Good afternoon. Welcome to the Harbor Hangar, although this is the Harbor Dining Room. Temporary hangar building spot. This is going to be Wifey's first build. Wifey's first airplane. We're starting with...
My favorite animal.
No, sorry. This is the Simple Scout.
What?
This is the practice one. So... one of the things that got Wifey so excited to get in on flying was seeing the lights at CEF and the night flying. And then she started looking around at the FT kits and planes, and she saw one that was called the Sea Otter, which is her favorite plane. Her favorite animal is the actual sea otter. And she said, well, that's my goal now, right?
Yeah.
To build and fly the sea otter.
That's my airplane.
To prep her for that, I went...
We live on a farm. Hay season.
You know. So I went on the Bixler's recommendations of one of his favorite starter trainers is the Simple Scout. And so that is the one That's what we're starting with, is the Simple Scout. And she just did the motor pod, motor mount power pod.
And
she did. I just showed her and she knows what to do. And we're going to use, because this is a home build, we're going to use Dan Sponhol's little motor mount firewall thingy. It's 3D printed. It's super cool. I'll put a link to where that is. So we're going to put glue just around the right on that bumpy edge there.
Okay.
And then that'll slide in just onto the right there, just like that. So, put glue on that guy.
All over? Just a little bit.
Just, you know, a little bit more than you did in the channels. That's a good amount. Music courtesy of our son. Now we've got a motor pod. Next, we're gonna peel the centers out of these. These are the turtle deck supports.
And you're gonna get what they call seafoam. And it kind of means, so the A is, you know, A for above, B is for the side, and C doesn't stand for anything, but like folds over itself like a C.
Okay. Put glue on this whole face. Not a lot, just, you know, on a string there and then a string in the middle.
Because it's not structural, it's there to hold the turtle deck shape. And yeah, just a decent thickness.
The next thing will be the fuselage. These channels here are gonna come out just like we did for the motor pod.
Okay.
Yeah, so you start that in, I'll start at this end. Yeah, use your fingernails to get in there. So you're on part of me. Perfect.
So this is gonna be a B fold, as indicated. Right there. So instead of grabbing the middle one and like pressing it in so that they end up on top, we'll take the side and press down and fold it that way so that it ends up beside.
Perfect. And press down so that it goes into the slot.
Oh no.
Not okay.
I messed up. No, it'll be okay. No, remember these doublers that I told you about? These guys? These are supposed to go in here, like that. So that's what we're gonna do. We can still get to them and we can still see where they line up. But if we were following the Bixler instructional video, which we're not, we're just going off my memory.
We're winging it. It's an airplane pun.
So if you're building the Simple Scout for the first time, anyone watching, go check out the FT instructional, you know, process video. I'll put a link to it in the description. All right, this guy is gonna go here. But first, we gotta take this edge off. Good job.
Thanks.
All right, we're gonna continue and put the finishing touches on the fuselage here. We have just some front closeout things to do, and then put some tape on these seams on the backside here. Put glue here, and then use this foam and like press it. You use it instead of your fingers to press around like that.
Really good job at not putting too much glue.
Mm.
It's something that I'm like the opposite at. Usually.
That, you smarty pants.
See that?
Yep.
But don't let it get stuck. Glued there.
So then you lick your finger.
You so lick your get, finger.
And then you get stuck with glue and you press it in there. Licking your finger does two things. One, it
gets
keeps
it
your,
wet.
Yes. Okay, it does three things. It gets your finger wet. Then it also protects your finger from getting burned.
You're and the only funny one.
Getting stuck with glue. I know I'm not. All right, so now we need to do this one. So put glue there and roll it that way. It's okay. So that right there.
If you can compare, this is the one he shaved and put a little cut into, and that's the one we just folded.
Yeah.
This has a nicer edge.
But the good news is that's where the power pod is gonna slide into.
So it's not even gonna matter.
And you're not gonna see it. we're gonna do just one strip basically right here, and we'll cut away. We'll cover that up, but then we'll cut it away.
Okay. So center it and line this edge up to that end there and let it run out and center it over here too. No, center it on the tape. And then we'll fold it down both sides.
Oh, let's do this. So we'll pop these guys out. And I will grab the turtleneck formers. These two are identical. They go here. Let's see how they fit. So they should be a little bit snug. To make them go in easier, we'll take our fingernail and just kind of scrunch the edges of the foam like that. And that way it'll slide in easier. The front guy, this one, is just gonna sit right on the front like this, and then wrap around like that. Yeah, you wanna put glue right in here, and then a little bit on this flap. These guys, you're just gonna put glue, since there's nothing, you know, in the hole for this to stick to, just put glue here and there, and then stick them down. Great. We're doing the tails now. She wrapped up the fuselage. We're good with that. I'll show you real quick. We did some tape on the edges.
A little reinforcement.
And reinforcement on the tail skid. So we got that taken care of. So that's good to go. The turtleneck we're going to do later once we get the servos in because we need access. So now we're going to do tails because we need to have the tails on before we do the servos because that's what they connect to. We'll start with the horizontal because it's a little bit easier. So crack that. So that's the elevator line there. Just sort of crack that open.
Up or down?
So, sorry, away, yeah, this way.
I mean,
no, it's a fair question, and it's just not a question I would have thought to answer. So thank you for asking it.
I ask the dumb questions.
No, she asks the necessary questions. What we need to do first is we need to bevel this edge here. You can do either one, but I like, if I can, I like to bevel the one on this side to leave more meat and foam on the elevator side. So, I'll show y'all start it and you can continue. If you cut through, don't worry about it because we can always tape it back on. So, I've done that plenty. So, we're gonna open this up real wide and use the like meaty part of the blade and do a real shallow angle like this. So we basically want a 45 to the foam, not 45 of the knife. So I'm gonna go in here and get to that paper there. And we might need a new blade, yeah. You'll want the sharpest blade you can have when you're doing the bevel. So that's what I love about this thing. Okay, start it.
Go in there, and I like to rest my finger right here, like that, and that sort of helps to hold the confidence angle there. And then I just kind of draw along. And then I'm like, that. And then I'll just pop out, and then you can continue. And then I'm
okay, so finger under here. What were you saying?
So let me see how I hold it. I hold it like a pen, like a big fat pen.
Okay.
And then this wants to be really angled like that, and then sort of match that bevel angle there.
It's okay, you got a good bite. Okay. And do kind of a drawing motion toward yourself. There you go.
And I just realized that I'm showing you the way I do it, which is sort of a more, no, you don't do that. And cut your thumb that way. But
that's how I cut my fruit.
I know, it's true. I want to just say a disclaimer for youngins that are doing this or other newbies. Josh Bixler shows how to do this where you lay this flat on a table edge and you can hold this and have it, and it can be much more stable instead of holding it in the air. When you do these bevel cuts. So I would definitely try that first. But props to you, wifey, for your first ever bevel cut on camera and ever.
Yay!
For doing a good bevel. So now this has room to move, see? And you did great. And we didn't cut through the other piece of paper here. So we're good there. So now I'm gonna get a scrap piece of foam ready and we're gonna open this up and put a bead down about maybe halfway and then take the foam and squeegee it onto the face there and kind of go.
Should I do more than I normally have been doing?
Yes, do more. You're gonna put a big fat bead because then we're gonna spread it all the way down. What that does is it seals this edge. Because if you pull on this, it could peel off. Mm-hmm.
So this is kind of sealing the hinge. Instead of having to do, you can write on the middle, on the paper edge. That's fine. It'll all get squished in. Yep. Just wiping. Yep, wiping. And you'll clean up the edges to all the way down. A little quicker. Yeah. And now try and pick up the excess on the sides there.
Oh, bunch of hair. Oh, wifey got
this
her first blue bird.
Mess. Should have done a little less like
no,
I do.
You did perfect. That looks great.
Okay, so any females out there, pull it all the way back. Your hair.
So this is good. This is good information for all builders.
That's not fun.
Next on the elevator is we're going to seal the leading edges, and you could do the whole way around, but we don't really need to, and it just adds weight. And this isn't going to be like a combat plane or anything, but mainly the leading edge.
It's not.
Oh, you could use it for combat. So we're sealing the leading edge because that's the one as you land, the grass and stuff is most likely going to, you know, run into it. And we just want to keep that nice and, you know, together. So the way we do that is I cut some of these little pieces with a little channel in them. This is the width of the foam. So we're gonna do this. I'll do one.
So we're gonna put a big fat bead again about halfway. And then press that in there. And then press that in there. And go a couple times to use up whatever you got on the squeegee. And there you go.
It's good.
Great.
Awesome. Now we're gonna do same thing on the rudder.
What's a rudder?
Good question. The rudder is actually...
We're going to just pretend like I'm totally new to airplanes, even though I've been around airplanes for the last...
It's true. 16, 17 years.
We're going to still pretend I'm brand new. Because well, I am.
That's a really good question that you asked, though, because the rudder is actually specifically just this part of this thing. This whole thing is called the vertical stabilizer or vertical tail.
Okay.
But the rudder is the part that moves. So I should have said we're going to work on the vertical tail because this is the horizontal tail and this is the elevator. So good distinction. This one's a little trickier though because we got two pieces to deal with. So here you break the other side open, yeah, down. And again, we're going to bevel the fixed side and this is going to slot into the fuselage once we're there. So,
okay, can I try the table cut?
Yes, you can. So what you're going to do, we're going to do it this way.
Okay.
And I'll get this out of your way. So now you want to put this basically right at the edge here.
Okay.
So you're going to use your hand to hold that down. And the motion and like the angle of the knife and everything is the same. Mm-hmm. But you're going to now, you'll be able to hold it like a normal knife hold instead of the big fat pen hold that I was doing.
Okay.
Okay, you want to angle it more there. Yeah. And then sort of plus, mm-hmm. And then angle more that way. So you get more bite on the knife. Yeah. And then
we'll
draw motion down, like, yeah, that way. So it
kind of
saws the blade. So it uses the blade as a saw. And it helps to make a smooth cut.
So
do the same thing on this little tab there.
Very good. Okay. So yeah, that is the preferred, safer method. And again, we're going to do the seal the edges. What I'm doing, the reason I'm licking...
He likes to get his spit in there.
I know, the reason I'm licking and sticking is so that we can... you don't want the glue to cool and dry with it like this too much, because then it'll be real hard to fold it back. But you also don't want to fold it back on itself while the glue is setting, because then it'll stick that way.
Mm-hmm.
So by licking and sort of running some, you know, moist, cold finger along the edge, it sort of... gives it a rapid cool, but also the moisture helps it to from sticking to itself when you fold this back. And that way you can get the motion in there. Here we go. Rudder and vertical stab done. Alrighty, so we've got servos and push rods
and horns.
So these are servo horns and these are control horns. They're both kind of control horns, but it's like this one goes on the control surface, this one goes on the servo. The elevator's gonna go on like this, and the pre-cut slot there is on that side, the left side. So this slot is gonna be our elevator slot. And so we're gonna take, we're gonna take this guy off the servo horn temporarily and set him aside and basically stick this through here and then sort of just work it back and forth in the slot so that it gives it a little bit of room to move
through the entire
Yeah, run it along the whole slot and you can kind of bend it, you know, left and right to make some room. Good. So now we're gonna stick them in that way. And go all the way forward. There we go. Oh, hang on. Pull it up. And then we're gonna pull them through this hole in the bottom that I cut out off camera. Good. And now rotate it so that, you wanna keep pushing it on so that the plastic horn is on this part of the Z-bend.
See it? No,
okay. I'm gonna go like that.
Okay.
Yeah. So you can do the rudder next time. So he's in there. Now we take the elevator, bring the elevator over here. Sorry, the horizontal stamp.
I was like, I don't remember which one.
Flip them over because we're upside down. And then we're going to temporarily put him on here. And just to measure where this guy goes. And so we're going to clip this wire so that it will be in line, so that it can be in the right spot for this horn. And we're going to do a Z bend, so we're going to give ourselves a little bit of room. About there-ish. Take this guy here and put him right up against my thumb.
Ooh!
Right, all the way into the bottom of the jaws. Yep. And then you might need two hands. I need two hands when I do it. Keep going. Yeah! All right. And now we gotta pay attention. We gotta think. I know.
Whoa.
We need to make sure that we do the Z bend in the same orientation that it just was. So
can't we figure that out based off of this?
We can. That's what we're going to do. Oh. I'm just saying we can't go just Z bending willy-nilly. We want it to be this way because we want the pivot to be in this axis. So we need to grab the wire that way. Now I'm going to check my servo and make sure it's... Yep, he's good. Z-benders are... there we go. Okay. Can put that guy on. So he's going to end... He wants to end up being this way. So we need to put him through the hole like that.
Which hole?
The top hole. It's already got a bigger...
Okay. Hole.
And then keep going around. Kind of swivel it, remember, just like the control horn was. Yeah, there you go. And now do a test fit of that horn. Press this on the table so it's flat. Yeah. Now you can do a test.
This part?
Yeah. So both of those tabs are gonna fit in there. Yep. So now take that out and you're gonna put a normal size bead of glue right in that slot. Here, I'll hold this out of your way. Good. Now stick that guy in there. Press all the way in. There we go.
Wiggle.
Now we did, I got ahead of myself a little bit because we didn't actually glue the horizontal on, but that's okay because this will just pivot out of the way. So we're gonna put glue here and then stick the horizontal on.
On both sides.
On both sides.
Okay.
Yep. Stuck on both ends, we're good. Very good. Now that that's glued and this is glued, we can put some glue on our servo.
Yeah, we can.
And actually stick him in place. Oh, before we glue the servo in, I forgot. You get to play with this. This is a servo tester. And we're gonna use, because these are not high voltage servos, we're gonna use our handy dandy FT BEC, which is basically, it takes the voltage from anything, a higher voltage battery, steps it down so we don't fry the servo.
So
this plugs into this first slot, and then we can test up to four servos at once, but we only need to do one. So we're gonna, so plug that guy in there with the yellow wire on the top.
Next to this other one.
Next to the other one, yeah. In any one of those four.
Oh.
Good.
Okay.
Now, plug in the battery.
To this one.
To that guy. Great. Now, you can turn that and it's moving the servo. Now, it's not doing anything because the servo is not, you know, fixed.
Okay.
So, press this button here that says select. That centers the servo. And then let's check and see... that, yep, the horn is in the right spot. Could we, if it was, if the horn was off when we hit center, then we just take the screw out and we move. Oh, now the next mode is it's going through the full range of motion. Of the
servo. I was like, ooh.
She's playing with buttons. She's pushing my buttons. That was back to where you had it for the knob. So push the button again to make it centered, or you can just, you know, put it at 1500. Okay, now unplug the battery first, just because it's a good practice to always unplug the battery. Because I accidentally left a battery plugged into a BEC once, and then the battery was dead and no longer good. So save our battery to unplug it first. Yeah. So now we can place, we visually look here, we see this is where we want our elevator, flat and centered. That is where we'll glue the servo down. So
now I'm ready.
Now you're ready. So now put some glue on the servo. I'll get my fingers.
All over your fingers.
Yep, all over my fingers. She's giving me a good lesson in not over gluing. Because I have a tendency to, yeah, overdo and over glue. I'm sorry, I did
you
this part for you. No, I didn't mess it up,
no.
But I will let you do, I'll make you do the rudder servo.
Yes.
Because this is supposed to be your build.
Yep.
And you're doing awesome. And it's very hard for me to not just take over and finish.
Yes, this is taking yeah. 3 days, and he has told me twice he has wanted to finish it without me. So, lesson in patience.
I have to scoot the servo down because it's going to run into the wing. I did mess it up.
See why I should have done it? Dude.
Okay, you know what? You get to do it.
Yay!
Okay, see this slot?
That's the wing.
That's where the wing goes. We're going to cut that out right now so that we can see where the wing goes. So we don't put the servo in the way of the wing, because the wing,
that's
when we assemble
idea.
It, right? When we're going to slide the wing all the way through. If I had left
other
the servo one. Right where I put it,
right.
The wing would not go in. Okay. Okay, now this time I'm going to put glue on. And you are gonna.
Now I have a messy servo.
They're, you know what? They're gonna be messy. They're gonna be on the inside. So I'll put glue on here, and then you're gonna hold it like I'm holding it, and then reach in here and stick him down, but don't stick him down so that you can see him.
Okay.
Stick him down, and then you can.
Anywhere against the wall.
Yeah, anywhere vertically here, and then you can slide him back and forth as the glue is setting, and when you look at that, you want it to be flat. Okay? With, yeah, there you go.
Okay. Does it look like it's in the right spot?
It looks like it's a little down. You need to push it that way. Yeah. Oh, there we go. Now we can both see. Nice. So, you want to play with the servo tester again?
Do I?
Yeah, because now we can check and you can actually see the thing move. So that guy goes.
Let me try.
Okay.
Please. I go here.
Yep.
Battery here. Do I do the battery first?
I like to do the servo first.
Okay. Yellow line up.
Very good.
And then battery in. Okay. So back to center.
Good, but you can just play with it.
Oh.
Pretty good.
Battery, unplug.
Battery unplug.
Servo, unplug.
You
other
can
cord.
Leave that one unplugged. You can leave that one plugged in.
Leave that cord plugged in. Check.
All right. Do a test for you. Just keep that out of the way. We need to go to there with the push rod. Okay, that's gonna
so
put...
So do we have room to fix that one or no?
We do, yes we do, because we have about an inch extra on the servo, or from where we want to put the servo. Would you like to do this part too?
Okay.
the horn is going to be this way. So the Z-bend needs to be this way. If you don't have a Z-bender,
get one.
Get one, or
click on this link here. No, I'm just kidding.
You can use pliers, regular needle-nose pliers, probably beefier ones than this for this wire, but needle-nose pliers like this, you can basically bend it down, and then you can bend it over, and you get sort of a modified Z-bend. But we have a Z-bender, so we're going to use it. Horn goes... Don't break the horn. Don't break the horn. Okay.
Yay!
He's going to go that way. Now he's on. Now we can glue the vertical tail on. So, and we're going to do this in the other order from the elevator. We're going to glue the vertical on and then glue the horn in. So do that now. Cool.
Beans.
Cool bean. Oh, I get it. We want to look and make sure that it's 90 degrees perpendicular to the elevator. How's it look?
Where am I looking?
You're looking like at the back end and see how the vertical and the horizontal, do they look?
Good.
Good?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. He's ready to get glued into the rudder. And so do a little test fit of the horn into the rudder. Good. Pull him back out.
Down here?
Yep. Okay. Now, this guy, since we took the horn off, you get to screw the horn back on. So there's a tiny screw.
Into the center?
Yes, into the center.
Righty tighty.
That's right. Let's check this guy and see if he is centered. Looks good.
It's going in the middle, big hole?
It's going in, yeah, the big hole.
And it's going on this way?
No, because it's gonna go on that way. Yes. Okay. Yep. Great.
Like that?
Yep.
Okay. Yep.
So hold on to him like that. And I will give you glue.
But it's gonna go on that wall?
Yes.
Okay.
You ready?
Ready.
And let me get
pinchy.
That's right.
Am I still pushing it back?
Well, first stick it to the wall, and then you can slide it back and forth.
Oh, and now, is it?
So, yeah, now it looks centered.
Yeah, it does.
Here, you can put your wires on the fuselage.
I'm gonna. Ooh.
I have to tell myself, okay, what would I do next, and just tell you to do it.
I'm pulling them forward?
Yeah. All right, so now that those servos are in...
Wings!
Before we leave the fuselage...
Not yet.
Not yet. We're going to do the turtle deck.
Not yet.
This way. All right, we got pieces of tape. We're going to do the center portion first. Basically, you're going to put glue on both of these guys and then take this and stick him down and tape... and stick the tape down, and then we'll come back and put and tape the front and back on.
So if you just grab the tape and stick the tape down. Yeah.
That is great placement.
Thank you.
Okay, so now take the short, and I'll put on this side. But don't stick this one down.
Because I have to put the glue.
Because we need to put glue right there.
Yeah, I can move this forward on.
But it doesn't hurt.
Okay. What about that tape?
We'll just cut that away. Now, your fuselage is done. Yes, wings. And even though there's like a whole, you know, two more sheets of foam board, the wings should go quicker because there's less operations to do here. We want to pop that out. That's the servo hole.
Done.
And also that little guy there. That's a relief for the control horn. And then I'll do the other wing. And then this, you need to crack this open all the way down and pull that channel out.
Just on both sides.
On both sides, yeah.
I'm gonna let you do this, but no, I'm gonna get in there and I'm gonna help you.
Well, cause I want you to have an airplane that's done and I like to build airplanes.
Ow!
Hot glue's hot.
Okay.
Yep.
Thought you were gonna do something else while I was doing this.
I did it already.
I'm just so fast.
Well, there was only one thing to get. Yeah, man, my hot glue gun. Ooh, I think that's skin.
Leave it alone. So watch out for that hot glue then.
Yeah. Pro tip, hot glue is hot.
You can't help yourself.
I can't.
Get there faster.
All right, this one is not marked. Well, it's A or B. And I'm gonna go check the plans really quick.
It's A fold.
I've consulted the plans, it's A fold. So that means side plates end up above. So the way we do that is we take the bottom one and we press it in down into it. We're doing the bottom one first. We're gonna put glue down in the channel and we're gonna grab the whole thing and go like this.
Stop doing what you're doing.
And I am going to help you just because it's long.
This way.
Yes, that way. Exactly. Press down and rotate. You can do the glue, though.
The glue's going.
It doesn't matter. Just put glue in.
Great. Okay,
one side down. Other side.
So what is this?
This is the wing spar.
What does it do?
So it does two things. It, when we fold the wing over, it keeps the top surface from just being stuck to the bottom surface. It also, mostly, it provides the structure that helps the wing not to bend where it shouldn't bend.
Okay, no bendy.
No bendy.
Okay. Wings.
The wings. Yes. We're going to do one half at a time. And then we'll stick them together. And then the dihedral gauge, I'll find, is somewhere. Yeah, let's do that. So we're going to actually just crack that one open. And also, this channel needs to come out.
There you go. You can help me.
I'm going to do the other wing. Well, on a wider channel like this, it's harder to roll. I'll be honest. What?
Okay.
That's okay. We have tape and glue. We can fix it. Actually, of all the things to break on the thing, that's going to get glued down and go on the inside of the wing, so no one will ever know unless they watch this episode.
All of you people.
Here, watch. I'll make you feel better.
You don't have to.
Yeah, I broke mine too.
Except you didn't go,
Well, that's because I'm used to breaking things. This is your first time ever breaking something on your airplane. I break airplanes all the time.
Yeah. Should go to.
So this is a C fold. This is the first thing we're gonna do.
Oh my God.
You made it easier on yourself because now you can do it one half at a time. So that's how glue goes in the channel and on this surface, and the whole thing just folds over onto itself. And I'm ready with more glue for you.
Okay. In the channel.
Yep. Folded it too far.
Oh.
Oh.
Ay, ay, ay.
Lick it. You okay?
Yeah.
Here. I gotcha. Okay, that's done on that one. Let's do the same thing on the other wing.
Bam.
Okay, well, that one sets, grab the other wing, and we're gonna do two bevel cuts. Ooh. Actually, three bevel cuts. So this one is gonna get a double bevel. We're gonna bevel it on this edge and this edge. And on the ailerons here, this one is gonna get just one bevel, just like you did on the rudder and the elevator. Get your angle like that. There you go.
Great.
Check. Great bevel again. Awesome. Okay, so now we'll do sealing of those edges. Now we're joining the two wing halves together. So cut you this piece of tape. We're going to just tape this. So this is the bottom, this is the top. We're going to just tape the bottom together. So just put that right there at the seam.
This way?
Yep.
Over that hole?
Yep, we'll cut the hole out later. That's just there to let the wires come out. So now we'll flip this guy over. And we're gonna put glue down in that crack right there. And kind of just press that, and here, we can squeegee that. Now we're gonna put the wing spar on. If you'll notice that this hole is smaller than that hole, and the reason for that is when servos will come through here, this hole is the size of both these tabs here, but when it goes through here, we'll pass the wire through from the bottom, and then they come down and the servo will sit right there. Dun. So that's how those get installed. So for that reason, we glue it this way, and we'll line it up with those marks there. And it should go, yeah, straight end to end. So just put glue on that, the whole thing. And we'll kind of slide it back and forth to get the glue to stick. And we're gonna, basically, we wanna look and try and line up the servo holes. Those are the important ones. Did I mess you up?
Yeah, if you push over too far, then I'm not lined up.
Oh, we need to slide that down. There we go. Make sure we're lined up on the... Next, we're gonna use a barbecue skewer.
Skewer.
Skewer. Barbecue skewer.
And a screw on
the end. A green screw!
Mm-hmm.
I was looking for that.
You're welcome.
So we're gonna use this, and we're gonna draw down in this, just like that.
Okay.
So you keep going, or you can stand up, do, and that's basically gonna make it easier for the wing to bend. Great, do the other one. Awesome. We'll do these one at a time. Actually, I like to crack this. Or maybe not. We'll just fold it. So put your hand there. And so we're gonna go over right there. And something I like to do, and this is a feature of the flight test wings, is they have this under camber basically, which is where the bottom surface stops and then the top surface is still here. When you cut these out and when you do the bevel, not you, but anyone, you can get a rip in the paper on the upper surface when you do this fold over right here. So what I like to do is just put a piece of tape right there. And that keeps the paper from ripping. So have it go out basically to where the radius starts to curve. Stick that down, and then this part that is flopping out here, just leave that, because when we fold it over,
just
leave it alone, because when we do the fold over, it'll stick to the bottom. And so let's do the practice fold to get this guy ready. We'll press.
Yeah,
you don't have to put glue here. But it's going to be here, here, and here.
Okay, where am I putting glue?
So here, here, and here. Just to the middle. We'll do one side at a time.
All right.
And go a little quicker so that the glue doesn't have to get this out of your way. You want to concentrate the pressure over the spar mostly.
You're holding your side.
My side's done. But you can put your hand on mine. That lovely long spar we have to cut, because the whole wing, actually we might not need to cut, we can probably just kink it, yeah. So we're gonna put glue down in there, and then I'm gonna get a piece of tape ready, and then we'll lift this up and I'll slide the gauge underneath and you stick the tape down on the center. So glue down in there. So hold that side down for me. And I'm gonna lift this up and slide the gauge under the wing. It's not even that high, but okay. So I got that. And you go ahead and stick the tape just right over the glue. We are done! Wifey Simple Scout is ready to fly, all except the final ingredient. So we get the honors of putting your propeller on. Yep. Yeah, it's a lot now. I didn't give Wifey a wrench.
Not my fingers though.
All right, well, it's on. We'll get a wrench before flight.
It's
better. It's, oh. All right, Thank you for hanging out with us and watching Wifey build the Simple Scout. I'm so proud of you and so glad to have you on board. We'll put some paint on it, or you get to choose, you know, how you want to color it. So we can tell, you know, up from down, left from right, all that good jazz.
Sparkle, sparkle.
Sparkle, sparkle. Yeah, we got some good rhinestone ideas, which I'm all for. That's going to be super fun. It'll be unique. I haven't seen a rhinestone airplane yet, so that'll be fun. Thanks for building with me, Rifle.
Welcome. Thanks for teaching me about airplanes.
Always. And thank all of you for hanging out with us at the Harbor Hangar. And see you next time. Bye.
Bye.